Hey guys, what's going on? Inception here, and welcome to another video. Ladies and gentlemen, we have the new Air 9 to review today. We got Braithwaite. So we're going to go ahead and give him the Marksman Chemistry style because I've taken a look at his dribbling stats. So I do think that it makes the most sense. And obviously, I want to try him out with it because of the way that his dribbling is actually formatted with the agility and balance at an average body type. So, yeah, with Braithwaite, we're taking a look at a card that is 5'10", medium-high work rates, which is definitely very interesting. He's definitely going to be, I think, target man-oriented, so we may have to force to get him behind out of him just to get some runs, but it could actually work out well for him. We'll see. Right-footed, 4-star skills, 4-star weak foot, so obviously meets the minimum requirements to be good in this game. You know, physical type striker, they need the 4-star. Player traits, he has the flair traits, so no finesse shot trait, no outside foot shot trait. In-game attributes, he's at 94-94, which is good. You don't have to improve that, I don't think. He's a physical type striker, so you're not going to rely a lot on like his crazy, aggressive, accelerated runs, you know. Base guard stats for shooting set up really nicely with the marks. We're going to be boosting the long shots to a 98 while making his finishing perfect at 93 attacking, positioning with medium-high work rates. Base guard stats for passing is good. You don't have to look at that too much. Dribbling we will be experimenting with in game because of the body type that he has. 96 heading accuracy is cool to work with considering he's 5'10" with some pretty good physical traits as well, because with the Marksman Chemistry style, this card does have the 96 strength and 99 jumping, which is again very helpful for the body type that he has with the height that he has. So definitely some good stuff there, but very curious to see how this Braithwaite performs in-game. Definitely looks like a very, very interesting card. With the way that we are going to be using him in-game, we're going to be using him in a... I want to use the 3-5-2. I've been using this from FIFA Analyst recently, and it's a pretty cool formation. We'll do that. So we'll do Braithwaite here, Ansu Fati... Sergio, we'll put here, Larson here, perfect. The tactics, I believe, was press after possession loss, and then it was balance 6 and 6, I think. Yeah, so 5 and 5, 6 and 6, and then the instructions were stay forward. We'll do that for both of them, because I don't know what their characteristics are like yet. Stay forward, one of the CDMs, because we're going to be reviewing Delaney 2. Hoiberg's not really attacking, so we're going to put him on defensive as well. This one is going to be just get into the box, stay wide and get into the box. I think that's what it was. Yeah. So stay wide. Which one is it? Stay wide, get into the box. Yeah, that's the one. Okay, cool. So yeah, we'll try him on the 3-5-2 and we'll see how he plays in game. Yo, Braithwaite's dribbling is low key, like not that bad actually. Ooh, Braithwaite, take it easy, buddy. Air 9, relax, okay, take it easy. Oh, man. I shouldn't have gone for the near post there. It doesn't make much sense. Especially with Marcelo, you know, that defensive AI block's gonna come in clutch. From that angle? There you go, Air 9. Yes, my boy. Let's do it. Guys, for a physical type striker, he's pretty enjoyable so far, for sure. Oh, I should have put more power on the finesse. Should have put more power. The medium-high work rates, by the way, is like super noticeable for him. 100%. It's definitely very noticeable. I actually, personal preference-wise, I like that authentic feel that Braithwaite has where he kind of asks for the ball and then pushes forward when the space makes sense. Like, his medium-high work rates don't seem to be a huge nuisance so far, which is pretty cool. Like, I like how authentic he feels, if that makes sense. Kind of cool that when it comes to like the physical type strikers, like EA are starting to get it, you know, when it comes to recently because of their upgrade system, like Schick, Ether, this card that we're reviewing right now, Lord Braithwaite, like they're doing a good job with the improvements that they're giving them considering that they're physical type strikers, you know. Yeah, take a look at his dribbling, man. I'm telling you, like, it's actually like pretty solid. You see how he kind of like goes back into position because of the medium high work rates? It's very obvious that he does that. So it's one of those things where it's like you totally could give him like a get in behind if you want him to consistently make those runs. Maybe a stay central get in behind. Definitely a situation you could do for sure. Oh, I wish that finesse shot came off a little bit better. Like, more directly to the side, especially since, like, he has, like, 99 shot power, 99 finishing. FIFA mechanics-wise, I feel like it should work, but... Finesse shots are not a high, consistent strike, you know? Like... Oh, Braithwaite. Braithwaite doesn't give up. Lower Braithwaite. Yeah, he does that all the time, eh? The way he's attacking AI kind of moves. It's cool, though, man. Oh, you want to do toxic celebrations. Okay. Okay. My boy, I gotta test all the defensive stuff, you know? Okay. He wants to do the thing, boys. I don't know, man. You know, and... Okay. Gonna do this on Braithwaite. Get in behind. Perfect. Contradict the instructions a little bit. Okay, cool. Well, Braithwaite does really well right there, to be fair, like with his dribbling. Again, considering he's a physical type striker. Let's go, Braithwaite, my boy. Good stuff, good stuff. Dribbling was good enough in that area. Oh, Braithwaite, love the movement, man. Love the movement. That combination play between Sun and Braithwaite was perfect. What is that face that he has? Oh, I'm sorry. I wouldn't even do the SBC just for the face. How dare you disrespect Lord Braithwaite like this? Oh no, if my player was in trap. Well, it's not the player there. The gameplay is horrific right now, so. Oh, Delaney, you absolute specimen. They gave Braithwaite the free kick stats, eh? Don't mind if I do, my boy. Don't mind if I do. Oh! Guys, like. You know what I'm saying? It's Braithwaite, bro. It's the best player in the game. Yeah, you know what, guys? His dribbling, I'm telling you, for a physical type striker, they did a good job with it, for sure. It's better than, like, Schick's dribbling. Look at that moving with the getting behind. It works really well with that medium-high work rate that he has. I could have made that pass through there. Look at the movement that he has. Oh, I shouldn't have scooped upwards. I had a feeling that wasn't going to work. Like, I should just do a regular left stick there. Ooh, the first time strike wasn't bad, man. Guys, his movement with getting behind is actually solid. Like, that's the instruction I would recommend for him because of the medium high work rates. Like, it's kind of contradicting that base characteristic of his really nicely, you know? Because it plays with the both of them, which is dope. Oh, no. Oh, I was trying to get that near pulse angle. The through balls in this game, man, they're just so awful. They're so awful. It's so bad that that through ball doesn't work properly to Braithwaite. Listen, man, he went through a lot of stuff right there, man. Mentally, physically, emotionally, he still had the ball. Might be in, actually. Oh my goodness, bro. This guy's crazy. Oh. You know when you actually like understand the stats of the cards and then like you take the first one, you're like, yeah, I got a good feel for it. I couldn't tell you what happened. I was trying to go for a lob pass there to Braithwaite, but the game told me to go do the thing, you know, so. Oh, you can't just foul Braithwaite like that, bro. Do you know what happens when you foul Braithwaite? Come on, bro. You know what happens. This is a little bit closer, so it's probably going to be like... Oh, you want to go in the net? Yo, my guy, don't even worry about it. I got you. Watch this. You can probably be like right here. I can't do it here with him. Oh, that one's not bad, actually. This one's not bad. Oh, crossbar. Oh. Okay, guys. So final verdict on the new Braithwaite card. So, guys, you know what? EA are starting to do a good job with the physical type strikers because these guys, they're not like the craziest to use in FIFA. They're not like the top tier meta cards, but EA are starting to improve them in a way where they're actually good to use in the meta of the gameplay. Now, of course, if someone's parking the bus, they have a bunch of defenders, the average body type is going to annoy you from time to time, right? But that's just the meta of the game. But generally speaking, the card actually dribbles really well. Again, physical type strikers, they just don't dribble that well most of the times. But again, with the recent cards EA have been dropping, you know, they're doing a good job with these guys. I gotta admit, okay? The marksman chemistry style makes his dribbling pretty awesome to work with because of the ball control, the dribbling, the reactions. 95 agility with 90 balance works well with the 5'10" height and the average body type because you are also increasing the shooting stats as much as possible. Now, with a card like Braithwaite, because he has medium-high work rates, you could play him to his base characteristic of medium-high where he kind of drops back from time to time. I felt like when I gave him the get-in-behind instruction, he actually performed really, really well. Honestly, he performed better than a lot of the mediums I usually use in the striker position with the get-in-behind instruction. Like, you guys could see the types of movement that he would make on the pitch. And, you know, it was great to work with, right? The base card stats for finishing at 95-95 is actually really noticeable. And this is why I always tell you guys before the chemistry style that that stuff is very important. Because when he took strikes with his right foot, with his weak foot, they were very good, powerful strikes. But again, you do have to get into the high percentage strike areas to, you know, have a little bit of consistency. So it's definitely one of those SBCs that I think that EA definitely did a really good job with. Again, for a physical type striker. Let's see how much he actually costs. Braithwaite is 137k. Great SBC. That's a great SBC. Yeah, they did a great job with that. In my opinion, guys, marksman chemistry style, getting behind instruction, I feel like you guys will definitely enjoy this card a lot. He has all the base requirements to be good in the gameplay that you're playing in, right? Again, he's not like some sort of full meta beast because of the body type that he has and stuff, but you guys will definitely enjoy using this card. He can actually perform in the gameplay well. It's like me using Ether. That's the card I always compare to now because ever since that Ether card and after, they've been improving the physical strikers really, really well. So, yeah, definitely a great SBC. I think you guys will definitely enjoy his card. Even his free kicks, man. His free kicks were awesome to take too. So, yeah, very fun review. I enjoyed this one a lot. So, hopefully you guys enjoy this video today. I'll catch you guys for next one. Peace out, dudes. Love you guys.